should point out that 18 is not a legitimate age down in the combat zone. In this industry, it's considered a good thing to come out of the garage. And unfortunately, Microsoft had more humbler beginnings. But we've had already a few good jokes at the expense of software tonight, and that's a good thing. Software brings the good with the bad, bad with the good. It's really the thing that I would say defines a personal computer. Of course, everybody feels that the universe rotates around them, but I think I'll point out some evidence to justify my point of view that things really do rotate around what we're providing through software today. In fact, if you look at a computer without any software, it's pretty boring. Typically, the screen is dead, and if you hit the keys, nothing happens. So we really need software. And this is what allows us to get out to a whole new class of users than we do today. Thank you.
You've probably heard of a company called Apple Computer, and you probably realize that it's really more than a company, it's a phenomenon. But he was, in fact, one of the principal forces which brought it from the garage to where it is today.
First, I think I'd like to take issue with something that Bill Gates said. He's talking about a personal computer without the software is kind of boring. Well, I think the software without the personal computer is also sort of boring. And that really gets me into the subject that we're talking about. What I would like to do is, at least from Apple's point of view, talk about what we foresee as major trends in the future of the user interface for computers. Still under the heading of ergonomics, we believe that the user interface should be indestructible. There shouldn't be anything that the user can do which will cause them great pain, such as losing 4 hours worth of data. I'd like to end by saying that I hope that the people at this table can collectively beat the socks off of the pantyhose business as we can develop.
Hardware manufacturers should put in a mechanism for protection that if authors still want to use it, that they should be allowed to do so?
Yes, I do. I would like to do that in such a way that we don't spend as much development dollars and effort as we are today. There are one or two instances of which I'm aware of, Bill, where it is mandatory that software protection be made available. It doesn't have to be totally brain-proof. The other piece is that I was asked to talk about what I see in the future, and I didn't pick next year. I picked about 10 or 15 years from now to talk about it. I think we'll be lucky if we can achieve the kind of standardization and elimination of software protection as an industry in a 10 or 15 year period. I'm just hoping that we can move along in those directions.